Welcome again everyone, and now we are going to study about the mitosis cell division. So first of all, I would like that you must watch the video earlier to starting the explanation. Let us watch it.
Metachores to microtubules from each metachores to micro anaphase and telophase. During prophase, the chromosomes condense and become visible.
What is told? It is told that during prophase, chromosome condensed. Earlier to prophase, the nucleus, inside the nucleus, the chromosome is present in form of chromatin fiber, and it is just a network where you cannot able to see the chromosome. But during, it is interphase, during interphase, but just after the interphase, when it goes into the prophase stage, the chromosome condensed means coiled and recoiled, the chromatin fiber coiled and recoiled to form chromosome, and chromosome is clearly visible like this. Yeah. Understood this topic? Every point will be explained by me very well. Try to understand it. Once again, if you want to
go through mitosis, which consists of prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. During prophase, the chromosomes condense and become visible, appearing as two sister chromatids held together at the centromere. The cytoskeleton.
So, what is told? Each chromosome contains two chromatids. Each chromosome contains two chromatids. See, this is a chromatid. This is one chromatid, and this is another chromatid. And this chromatid is connected at the center by a small structure, constricted structure. This structure is called centromere. This structure is called centromere, and outside you can see there is a button-like structure from where the spindle fiber get attached. This button-like structure is called kinetochore. I think you understood. So each chromosome condensed to form two chromatid, and each chromatid is attached together by centromere, and outside the centromere there is kinetochore. Let study further.
Centromere. The cytoskeleton disassembles as the spindle begins to form. In animal cells, centrioles play an important role in the distribution of the chromosomes in the dividing cell. The centriole.
What is told? There are so many cytoskeletons. Cytoskeleton means these are the cytoskeleton. This is also called aster, and this aster help to distribute the chromosome. This chromosome to get all together into the cell. So this cytoskeleton is remain attached with the centrioles. Yeah, this is the centrioles. You can see this is the centrioles, yeah. And you can see so many cytoskeletons are just a ray of sunlight appearing from here. These cytoskeletons help in the formation of spindle fiber and help in cell division in animal cell. But in case of plant cell, only cytoskeleton arrange itself. There is no centrioles. What I told, this is the centrioles, point to be noted. During the prophase stage, the centrioles go apart from each other toward the opposite pole to form a spindle fiber. You will see in the later video.
Migrate to opposite poles, establishing a bridge of microtubules called the spindle apparatus.
Yes.
And the nuclear envelope.
What is told? The two centrioles go apart from each other toward the opposite pole and form the spindle fiber, so that the chromosome get attached with it. See it.
breaks down. Towards the end of prophase, chromosomes attach, by proteins in their centromeres called kinetochores, to microtubules from each pole, moving the chromosomes toward the equator of the cell. During metaphase, all chromosomes...
So, I think you watched the video and you have already understood the different step of prophase during mitosis cell division. Let us study it more clearly in my given notes. Let us study. During the course of mitosis cell division, in this kind of cell division, in which cell divide to form two similar daughter cells, it is also called identical cell division because the daughter cells are identical to their parents. I have already told you about mitosis cell division is also called equational cell division because the number of chromosome in the mother cell is equal to the number of chromosome in each daughter cell. So it is also called identical cell division. So there are two different phases of mitosis cell division, that is called karyokinesis and cytokinesis. Karyokinesis, the definition of karyokinesis is very simple. Karyokinesis is division of nucleus. A mother cell has one nucleus, the nucleus get divided into two nucleus, and inside a single cell, inside a mother cell, the nucleus get divided into two daughter nuclei, and this is called karyokinesis. Further, the cytoplasm get divided, and then one mother cell forms two daughter cell with each nucleus. So karyokinesis is the division of nucleus into two daughter nuclei, and cytokinesis is the division of cytoplasm resulting into two daughter cells. So I think it has been cleared. Now karyokinesis is nuclear division, which is further divided into four main phases. What is it? Prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase. There are four main phases: prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Don't entangle them each other. These are in series and you have to write it or learn it in series manner. Let's study what are the processes. Obviously, after karyokinesis, cytokinesis has been followed. Now let's study what are the activity take place during the course of prophase. During the course of prophase involve in the condensation of chromatin material. As earlier I told you that during the interphase stage the mother cell contain a nucleus, and inside the nucleus the chromatin fiber is in form of network. It is in case of interphase, but in the beginning of prophase the chromatin fiber condense to form chromosome. This is the structure of chromosome, condense to form chromosome. So in this phase condensation of chromatin material take place. Second topic, migration of centrosome, appearance of the meiotic apparatus, and disappearance of the nuclear membrane. Three topic has been given over here. First, migration of the centrosome. What I told about that, a animal cell contain a nucleus. Just above the nucleus you can see there is a centrosome. The centrosome contain two centrioles, and the centrioles have so many esterases. So they migrate toward the opposite pole, means its centrioles, suppose this is a cell, and the centrioles get going apart from each other, go to the opposite pole and forms a network like structure. Okay, so migration of centrosomes appearance of mitotic apparatus. Mitotic apparatus means the apparatus that helps in the division of chromosome. So it has been made over there. And disappearance of nuclear membrane. The nucleus present in the cell, the nuclear membrane, this is the nuclear membrane, get disappear, vanished. Yes. Next topic, due to condensation, each chromosome become visible. Obviously it will be visible because earlier it was a network, and network is not clearly visible. But when it get condensed, means they get coiled, it can easily be visible, which can be seen by with two sister chromatid. I already explained you about sister chromatid, how the sister chromatid is get attached. This is a sister chromatid get attached with another sister chromatid with the help of centromere. So the two sister chromatid can easily be visible, and they are attached with the centromere. The nucleolus start to disappear. Once again, what is nucleolus? Inside the nucleus, there is a condensed area with dark structure. This structure helps in the formation of ribosomes. So this structure is also disappear. Nuclear membrane disappear, nucleolus disappear. Chromatin fiber convert into chromosome, and two centrioles going apart from each other toward the opposite poles. Next, centrosome has been undergone duplication. Centrosome divide into two. Duplication means the centrosome gives two centrioles, which I shown in the video, centrioles, and this centriole move opposite pole toward the opposite pole to form the spindle fiber, and mitotic apparatus completely form. Means now the chromosome is ready to divide. Understood? The figure is given over here. Yeah, it is the early prophase stage. You can see the network of chromosome, which is not clearly visible over here. There is two centrioles, which is not drawn over here. And you can see these are the chromatin fiber. Just below it is the early prophase stage. Now it is late prophase stage, means just after or late prophase. You can see the chromosome is clearly visible over here, and the nuclear membrane is disappearing. Nucleolus, which is not shown in the figure, is also disappeared, and the two sister chromatid, sister centrioles, go apart from each other and forms the spindle fiber and get attached it. So it was the end of prophase. Now we are going to study about metaphase. What happens during the metaphase stage? Let us see the video once again so that you can understand it.
Here of the cell. During metaphase, all chromosomes are aligned at the equator of the cell, called the metaphase plate.
What is told? During the metaphase stage, all chromosomes arranged in the linear fashion. Yeah, you can see all the chromosomes stand in a equatorial plane, in single equatorial region. Yes. Let us watch it once more.
Metachores to microtubules from each pole, moving the chromosomes toward the equator of the cell.
Yeah.
During metaphase, all chromosomes are aligned at the equator of the cell, called the metaphase plate.
Yes.
Anaphase begins with the degradation of proteins that hold sister.
So, it was the end of metaphase. Metaphase stage is obviously looking very simple and completed in very few lines, but actually it takes some time. Remember it. So what happens during the course of metaphase? Let us study. In this phase, chromosomes are completely condensed. Chromosomes are condensed and become thick and very small and thick, and can clearly visible under microscope. Understood? So it become thick and they appear very short, small. C sister chromatid and centromere become prominent. Means you can easily see the sister chromatid. This is the sister chromatid. One sister chromatid get attached with another sister chromatid with the help of centromere. Yeah, obviously the drawing that I made is separating two chromosome, sister chromatid apart from each other, but actually this structure is not actual. That is, I just make it to make you clear about that. That's all. So this is the centromere, and with the help of centromere, two sister chromatid get attached. So sister chromatid and the centromere become prominent. You can easily see the sister chromatid as well as centromere under the microscope. Next, what happens? All the chromosomes lie in the equatorial plane. All the chromosomes arrange the single mitotic plate or metaphase plate. It is also called metaphase plate. Next, what happened in the third topic? Mitotic spindle are fully developed. All the spindle fiber. Yes, I already told you the two centrioles goes apart from each other. In case of animal cell, not in plant cell. Plant cell has no centrioles, but spindle fiber formation take place as usual as in animal cell. Only this much is not present in the plant cell, means centriole not present, but all things are the same as in plant animal cell. So spindle fiber formation takes place and all chromosome arranged in the equatorial plate. Yeah, you can see these are the chromosomes that I am making in the blue, and they are arranged in the equatorial plate or equatorial plane. This is called metaphase. So it is ready to divide. Now what happens during anaphase stage? Let us study and see the video once again. Let's watch it.
With the degradation of proteins that equator of the cell. During metaphase, all chromosomes are aligned at the equator of the cell, called the metaphase plate. Anaphase begins with the degradation of proteins that hold sister chromatids together, freeing individual chromosomes. The free chromosomes are then pulled by their kinetochores to opposite poles. At telophase, a cleavage furrow forms in the center of.
I think you understood what happens in the course of anaphase stage. During the anaphase stage or during the anaphase, suppose this is the chromosome, and this chromosome is get attached by the spindle fiber. The both of the spindle fiber draw the chromatid, and the chromatid as drawn from each other, the centromere breaks. This centromere, after the breaking of the centromere, two chromatids get separated and goes apart from each other due to shortening of the spindle fiber. Means the spindle fiber is pulling the sister chromatid, and due to the pulling, the centromere breaks longitudinally, and due to the breaking of the centromere, the sister chromatid get separated and drawn from each other toward the opposite pole with the help of spindle fiber. Yes, very good. Let us study what happens during the course of anaphase. The chromatid of each chromosome break to form two chromosomes. Means one chromosome get divided and forms two daughter chromosomes. Understood? That's why the number of chromosome in mother cell, which was 46, remains 46 and 46 in each daughter cell. I think you understood. Means here one chromosome divide into two chromosomes and get separated into two daughter cells equally. That's why it is called equational cell division. I think you understood this topic. Yeah. Let's go up the next point. The formed chromosomes are pulled away. Yeah. From the center, from metaphase plate, they pulled away to the opposite pole by shortening of spindle fiber, because the spindle fiber is pulling the chromosome toward the opposite pole. Understood? So opposite direction by spindle apparatus. Next, what happens in the third steps? Let us study. The chromosome being pulled away appear like a bunch of banana. Bunch of banana. I think you have seen the banana. When it is pulled, it look like a banana. And during the midway of anaphase. Next, what happens? Its set of chromosome reach at the opposite pole of the cell mark. When it reached at the opposite pole, it is the end of the anaphase. You can see the figure of the anaphase over here. Yeah, the centrioles, this is the centrioles, draw the all chromosome toward the opposite pole, and when the chromosome reach at the opposite pole, it is the end of the. Now let us see what happens in the next phase, that is telophase. Let us see it.
Individual chromosomes. The free chromosomes are then pulled by their kinetochores to opposite poles. At telophase, a cleavage furrow forms in the center of the cell. This indentation is made from a constricting belt of actin filaments surrounding the equator of the cell, called the metaphase plate.
Yes.
Anaphase begins with the degradation of proteins that hold sister chromatids together,
yes,
freeing individual chromosomes. The free chromosomes are then pulled by their kinetochores to opposite poles. At telophase, a cleavage furrow forms in the center of the cell. This indentation is made from a constricting belt of actin filaments surrounding the inside of the cell's circumference. Chromosomes cluster at opposite poles and begin decondensing as the nuclear envelope reforms around them. The spindle apparatus disassembles as the microtubules are broken down into tubulin monomers that can be used to form the cytoskeleton of the daughter cells. In animal cells, cytokinesis completes cell division.
So I think you have understood what happened in a telophage stage. Means during the course of telophage, during the process of telophage, all the chromosome which has already been drawn toward the opposite pole, the chromosome uncoiled, means open, because it has been coiled during the prophase, it uncoiled to form the chromatin fiber as usual. Okay, so telophase is the final stage of karyokinesis. It is very well known to you. During the course of telophase, the chromosome with their centromere at the pole begin to uncoil. Yeah, it reopen. Which one? Coiled during the prophase, uncoiled, and become lengthened and loose, and very fiber-like structure has been formed. Network-like structure has been formed once again. When it was in interphase, as usual, it looked like in this phase. The nucleolus begin to reappear. Nucleolus, which has been disappeared during the prophase, again reappeared over here. Yeah, it has reappeared. Now, the nuclear membrane begin to appear. The nuclear membrane, which has been disappeared during the prophase stage, again reappear in this stage. The same thing happens, but just opposite to each other from prophase with respect to the telophase. Means in prophase stage, we have seen that the nuclear membrane disappeared, nucleolus disappeared, and coiling of the chromatin fiber into chromosome. But here you will see just opposite to each other. The chromosome uncoiled to form chromatin fiber, the nuclear membrane again reappear, the nucleolus again reappear, and the spindle fiber, which has been formed at that time, broken and dissolved, and the cytoskeleton spread into the cytoplasm. So let us study. The nuclear membrane begin to appear around the chromosome. Spindle fiber break down and get absorbed into the cytoplasm, and the two daughter nuclei are formed. Means in the single cell you can observe two daughter nuclei at the opposite poles. Yeah, this is the opposite pole. And what happened just after that? The cytoplasm makes a constriction at the center, so that it can easily be divided into two daughter cells. So constriction is seen at the center of the animal cell. And in case of plant cell, the cell plate formation takes place, which further help in cell division or cytokinesis. Later, we are going to study about cytokinesis. As usual, I had already explained you that the cytokinesis is the process in which cytoplasm is divided into two daughter cells. So the division of cytoplasm into two daughter cells is called cytokinesis. Later on, the cytokinesis is different in both the animal cell as well as in plant cell. In case of animal cell, the division start with a constriction, means the cytoplasm get constricted at the center. These are the two nucleus, and this is the constriction. The cytoplasm get constricted at the center, toward the center. So the constriction gradually deepen, it goes inside so that it can be divided and ultimately join and divide into two daughter cells. So I think you understood it, twisted like this and break into two parts. But in case of plant cell, it is just different. In case of plant cell, suppose this is the plant cell. Plant cell are mostly polygonal like. So in case of plant cell, the cell plate formation takes place at the center, and this cell plate goes toward the opposite pole and forms another cell wall, and this cell wall separate the two daughter cell. Again, I am repeating it. In case of plant cell, a cell plate, suppose this is the plant cell, a cell plate forms at the center and this goes to the opposite direction and meet at the cell wall of opposite poles and make a division which separate the two mother cell into one mother cell into two daughter cells. So let us study. In the primary cell wall, that is cell plate, forms at the center of the cell, that is partition appear at the center of the cell and grow outward to meet the external lateral wall. The cell plate represent the middle lamella. The cell plate is actually made up of cell wall. It is a kind of cell wall, and cell wall is three kinds. So the cell plate is one of the kind of cell wall that is called middle lamella. Okay, so between the walls and adjacent cell. At the time of cytoplasmic division, organelle like mitochondria, plastid get distributed. Means when the cell divides, the materials are equally distributed. Cell organelle like mitochondria, Golgi body, centrosome, lysosome, all are equally distributed toward the each daughter cell. Understood? So what are the significance of mitosis? Significance of mitosis. Mitosis is called equational cell division because the number of chromosome is remain equal to its mother cell and maintain the constant number of chromosome. Point to it. Maintain the constant number of chromosome in each daughter cell. It is one of the most important significance. Another, it ensures the equal distribution of nuclear and cytoplasmic content. Nuclear means equal distribution, means the number of chromosome is equally distributed to the daughter cell, and all the cytoplasmic content like mitochondria, Golgi body, centrosome, lysosome, all things are equally distributed among the two daughter or between the two daughter cells. The hereditary materials is also equally distributed, also mentioned over here, because the chromosome is nothing but the hereditary material. That is, chromosome is made up of DNA and histone protein. So it is also distributed equally. Next, it helps the growth and development of the organism. What are the most important characteristics of mitosis, or you can say significance of mitosis illusion, because all the organism on the world present is actually grow with the help of, means growth of the body take place with the help of only and only mitosis cell division. Point to be noted. Next, all the worn out, suppose there are so many worn out cells on the upper surface of the skin, or there are some cells which have already been dead, so these cells are replaced by another new cells with the which is produced by mitosis cell division. And mitosis cell division is also a mean of sex or sexual mode of reproduction among the plant. You have already seen so many plants which grow by artificial propagation and all, and this kind of propagation or reproduction can easily be performed due to mitosis cell division. So mitosis cell division help in the asexual mode of reproduction in case of potato, ginger, etc. Next, it cannot introduce variation. Yeah, mitosis cell division does not allow any kind of variation, because variation can only be seen in case of meiosis cell division. So it is the end of mitosis cell division. We will study the meiosis cell division in our other classes. Make the notes and also do the questions and answer that has been given in the book. And if you have any problem, you can call me or WhatsApp me on this number. Just I am giving you the number. It is 5. Yeah, this is the number. If you have any kind of problem, you can call me on this number. I can help as much as I can. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.